أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. هيا لسنا هيا لسنا هيا للفلاة هيا للفلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
الحمد لله ثم الحمد لله. الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا ليهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. لقد جاءت رسل ربنا بالحق. سبحانك يا ربنا لا نحصي ثناء عليك أنت كما أثنيت على نفسك. نستغفرك ربي ونتوب إليك، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، له الملك وله الحمد، يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير. وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا وطبيبنا سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم عبد الله ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله الغر الميامين وأصحابه نجوم الدين وعنا معهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. أما بعد، عباد الله، يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه الكريم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. الله سبحانه وتعالى in the Quran told us in a beautiful ayah the purpose of our life. He told us وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنْسِ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. I only created jinn and a human being for one purpose, is to worship me. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم made dua for one of the Sahaba, was young Sahabi, سيدنا عبد الله بن عباس. And he made dua for him that he will understand the inner meanings of the Quran. For this verse, he said, ليعبدون. The meaning of it is ليعرفون. To have a knowledge, to have معرفة of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what's this benefit us if we have a معرفة of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? When we look in the names of Allah and look at the Quran, the thing that Allah loves and what Allah can give us with this love, how we can get the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we look at the name of Dhul Jalal wal Ikram, Allah Dhul Jalal, the majestic, the owner of majestic, the one who gives you the majestic status. Well, ikram is the beauty, the jamal. So you have two sides that most of the name of Allah in these two characteristics, the jalal and the jamal. If you know Allah, most of us know Allah from the beauty side. When I got a new job, I have a new baby, I have a gift, something good happened to me, good health, good day, everything around me. This is jamal, beauty, to the ikram. Allah is giving me ikram. Allah is generous with me. Yes, I love Allah. He's generous with me. But Allah expects from me to say, Alhamdulillah, to have shukr. Because Allah loves the people of shukr. So when I have something good, and I thank Allah, on top of that, I get two things. One, لَإِن شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. If you thank me, I increase you. You get more and more. And the second thing, Allah loves the people of shukr, Allah loves the people of hamd. Allah yarda. Allah is pleased with shukr. Allah is pleased with hamd. And you have to remember, all our action, everything we are doing will stop once we enter Jannah except hamd. وآخر دعوهم الحمد لله. This never stop. Always thank Allah. Always have hamd in Jannah. So when we have something good, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then we get increase. So this is part of the ma'rifah knowing that everything coming for you is not your paycheck, it's not your exercise, it's not the doctor, it's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you have to thank Allah. Most of us, alhamdulillah, we are good at this. As a Muslim, we recognize this. We say alhamdulillah. Every day we pray, we say alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. We thank Allah. Now the other part, the jalal, the majestic. People of Ma'rifah, they knew that Allah wants you to know Him in both majestic and beauty. So when something bad happened to us, I get sick, somebody die, I'm laid off, I'm so and so, all of these bad things that we think happening for us, a lot of people, which is sad, they say, why Ya Allah? Why me? Why this happened to me? Instead, Allah told in the Quran, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الصَّابِرِينَ. Allah loves the people of patient. Allah be patient. So Allah will give you some hard time so you can gain love of Allah. So you acquire love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by being patient. There is higher than patient. This rida, you are pleased. You on your face, some arifin, I've seen it before, that if they kept jamal, they have a smile. If they got jalal, they have a smile. In both cases, they are happy. In both cases, they are satisfied with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then you, that inna ma'al usri yusra, inna ma'al usri yusra. With each difficulty, there is two ease. So they are satisfied with both. So as we said, the love of Allah. Now, part of the ma'rifah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah made us that we will sin. كل ابن آدم خطأ. All of us are going to have a sin. There's no doubt. But if we make tawbah, then what happened? إن الله يحب التوابين. Allah loves people of tawbah. So even sin is a way to acquire the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even the bad thing that we are forbidden to do, the result of it, we get love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we are increasing, coming close to Allah by having ma'rifah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the purpose of our life, to come close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of the shaykh who is the student of Shaykh al-Akbar, he have seen, Shaykh Muhyiddin al-Arabi, he have seen in his dream his brother who died. And he told him, what happened with you? He said, alhamdulillah, everything, we're welcome, everything is good. He said, no, tell me what happened. He said, no, we're treated well. He said, tell me, did you see him? He said, yarahu huna man arafa. The one who sees Allah after death is the one who have ma'rifah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The more ma'rifah, the more closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. On the day of judgment, Allah will tell us, ask what you want. Tell us what do you want. And most of the Muslims, they got confused. What should we do? They go to the people of the ma'rifah of Allah. They tell them, what should we do? And they tell them, ask for this and this and this. They are a source of guidance in this dunya and the akhirah. Allah told us in a hadith. Long hadith, I'm going to say the part of it. وَمَا زَالَ عَبْدِي يَتَقَرُّبُ إِلَيَّ بِالنَّوَافِلْ حَتَّى أُحِبُّهُ. My servant will come to me with an extra deed, not obligatory, until he gained my love. So there is a goal. We get the love of Allah. Because the moment Allah loves us, everything changes. The whole universe will serve you. And Allah will be your sight, your hearing, your hand, everything change. How do we get this? By the extra deed. Now most of the people, they know that nawafil, the extra deed is with the salah, we do an extra, you know, raka'at, or raka'at after maghrib, or six, and so on, all the salawat. With siyam, we fast Monday, Thursday, whatever it is. Zakah, on top of our zakah, we give charity. In hajj, we do the second hajj, or umrah, this all what? Nafila. But a lot of people, they miss the first one. Because five pillars. The first one is, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, wa ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. What's the nafila of this? The scholar, they say, the nafila of ashhadu an la ilaha illallah is dhikrullah and recitation of Quran. This is the nafila. You want to come close to Allah, you want to gain the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, sit and read Quran. Sit, come close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah said, أنا جليس من جالسني. I sit with the one who sit with me. And they say, من جالس جالس. Whoever sit with somebody, he acquire from him. If you sit with a generous person, you be generous. If you sit with somebody who is smiling, you be smiling. And so Allah, we're sitting with Allah. Then we acquire the mercy. All the things that Allah, the good characters, the thing that we need, even being mutakabbir, you'll be mutakabbir in your nafs. You'll be over your desires to put it down just by sitting and reading the Quran and making dhikr. This is ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. The second one is ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. And this is by the nafila of this is what? Make salawat al Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Doing salawat al Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us in the day of judgment, the closest one to me, next to me, he'll be next sitting next to me, أكثركم عليه الصلاة. The one who making salah on me the most. So the more you make salah on Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the more closer to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So by all of this I mentioned, what are we getting? We're getting the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. By ma'rifah of Allah from the Quran. What is the Quran? Wallahi, search. What's the thing that Allah loves? And what's the thing that Allah doesn't love? Inna Allah la yuhibbu, la yuhibbu, la yuhibbu. Go through all this. Try yourself to be in the category of the one that Allah loves. Not in the other category. One of the key of having a ma'rifah in your heart, that will be Allah will put it in your heart, will open doors for you, is the ayah يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ مَالٌ وَلَا بَنُونَ إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. On the day that your money, your children, anything you have in it's your own will not benefit you at all, except who come to Allah with a sound heart. قَلْب سَلِيم, pure and sound heart. So if I try to have my heart pure and sound, what do I get out of it? When Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the angels came and they split his chest, get his heart out. Sayyidina Jibreel said, قَلْبٌ وَكِيعٌ فِيهِ عَيْنَانِ تَسْمَعَانِ وَفِيهِ أُذُنَانِ فِيهِ عَيْنَانِ تُبْصِرَانِ وَفِيهِ عَيْنَانِ تَسْمَعَانِ. أو كما قال, he said, a very amazing, good, sound heart. In it, there is two eyes that can see. And there is two ears that can hear. That's why Rasulullah ﷺ, he told us, إِنِّي أَرَى مَا لَا تَرَوْنَ وَإِنِّي أَسْمَعُ مَا لَا تَسْمَعُونَ. I see what you don't see. And I hear what you don't hear. This is a qalb salim, a pure and sound heart. And this is for us to really be on a footstep of Rasulullah ﷺ. I have a heart, and in it there is two eyes and there is two ears. But do I see things? Do I hear things? This dunya is killing us. From this century that we have electricity, technology, and everything, this kills our inner eye. This makes us not, I mean, there is a lot of example of the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, who, some of them they talk to Sayyidina Jibreel, some of them they see the throne of Allah, some people they see the people in Jannah enjoying, some people they see people in fire, they are, and Allah, what does Allah told them? عَرَفْتَ فَلْزَمْ. You gain a status of ma'rifah, stick to it. And it's in Sahih Hadith. This is wallahi available for us. I once asked my sheikh, I said, I have a problem with my heart. What can I do? He said, look, take the heart of the Quran in the heart of the night for your heart. The heart of the Quran is Yasin. And the heart of the night is the half an hour or 1 hour or 10 minutes before the Fajr time, for the Adhan. Recite Yasin for the intention that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the owner of all the hearts, will fix your heart, will fix my heart. One way that we really can get into having a sound heart, a qalb saleem, even though we know during the day, I'm going to get angry, I have seen this, and talk of this, and I have this problem, my heart is psh. But if you look at the hadith where Rasulullah ﷺ was talking to Sayyidina Anas ibn Malik, he said, Ya Bunay, O my son, إن قدرت أن تصبح وتمسي وليس في قلبك غش لأحد من المسلمين فافعل. If you are capable in the morning and in the evening to check your heart and you have no wish, no hard feeling to any of the Muslims, then do it. وَعَلَمْ أَنَّ ذَلِكَ مِنْ سُنَّتِي وَمَنْ أَحْيَ سُنَّتِي فَقَدْ أَحَبَّنِي وَمَنْ أَحَبَّنِي كَانَ مَعِي فِي الْجَنَّةِ. Know that this action is from my sunnah. And whoever revived my sunnah, this is a certificate I can give him that he loves me. This is a sign that he loves me. And whoever loves me, he is with me in Jannah. وَمَنْ أَحَبَّنِي كَانَ مَعِي. You'll be with Rasulullah ﷺ if you love Rasulullah ﷺ. And you love him if you revive his sunnah. So that sunnah that Rasulullah ﷺ indicates, this is that, okay, you will get angry. But during the day, but in the evening, look at your heart, say, Ya Allah, I forgive all the bad things that Muslim did to me for the sake of gaining love of Rasulullah. In the morning, Ya Allah, I forgive everybody that did that to me for the sake of love Allah, Rasulullah. Definitely. When you love Rasulullah, Allah loves you, and you love Allah. In this way, you are working on your heart. In this way, first, no wish, no hard feeling. Even though it is when things happen, the best thing is to do when you have something with your brother or sister, you forgive immediately. But it's hard. I know it's hard. I know myself it's hard. But when the end of the day comes, Ya Allah, I want love of Rasulullah. I want to be with him in paradise. I want to gain ma'rifah. I want to know Allah more and more. So I want to forgive him for that sake. Same thing in the morning. So you have two checkpoints, you do it. Now, that's one thing. The other thing is, look in your heart whom you are inviting to. Look in your heart whom you are inviting to. I'll give you this hadith or this incident that Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, I look at it, he did this act just to teach us, radiallahu anhu. One day Rasulullah sitting, Sayyidina Abu Bakr sitting next to him, a strange man came, he started insulting Sayyidina Abu Bakr in front of Rasulullah. Rasulullah smiling, insulting him, Rasulullah smiling. And then Sayyidina Abu Bakr felt, enough is enough, not in front of Rasulullah, that's bad adab. So he opened his mouth and he started defending himself. Rasulullah stand up and start walking away. Sayyidina Abu Bakr ran to him, Ya Rasulullah, what's my life without you? I don't have life without you. Ya Rasulullah, he was insulting me, he was smiling. When I defended myself, he left. He said, Ya Abu Bakr, when he was insulting you, an angel was sitting here defending you. And I was smiling at this amazing, kama qala Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this amazing setup that you get all this from the angel whose dua is for sure accepted. But look at this. When you open your mouth, the angel left. Shaitan came. And I cannot be in the same place Shaitan is. I cannot sit with Shaitan. So, that's it. So for us, really, We work hard on our heart to clean it. Let's say before Fajr I wake up, I read Yasin and so on. And I wanted to gain the love of Allah. And then something happened during the day. I don't want shaitan to be in my heart. When a scholar said, you have the daughter of shaitan in your heart. And shaitan for sure will visit his daughter. Shaitan for sure he will visit his daughter. And his daughter is the love of dunya. The love of this thing that Allah made it for us to be a test. It can be in our hand, but shouldn't be in our heart. So, for us, we have to look up for our heart. Clean the heart. Forgive people. Have your goal is the day after, where you want to be next to Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Where you know, need to be close to Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. With having ma'rifah and love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم فيا فوز المستغفرين استغفر الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا وحبيبنا وقرة أعيننا محمد خير نبي اصطفاه رحمة للعالمين أرسله أرسله بالهدى والدين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره الكافرون. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى صحبه وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. عباد الله إن الله بدأكم بأمر عظيم. إن الله أمركم بأمر عظيم بدأ به بنفسه وثنى بملائكته قدسه فقال سبحانه وتعالى إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. وارض اللهم عن ساداتنا الكرام أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان علي وعن سائر العشر المبشرين بالجنة وعن عمي حبيبك وسبطيه وأزواج النبي وعن المهاجرين والأنصار وعن سائر أصحاب الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم وعن تابعين بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وعنا معهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم يا رب نسألك بجاه المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم أن تصلح أمة حبيبك المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم يا رب أكرم أمة حبيبك المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم أنصر أمة حبيبك المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم أعز أمة حبيبك المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم اجمع على الهدى أمر أمة حبيبك المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم اجبر أمة حبيبك المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم أغث أمة حبيبك المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم نسألك يا الله نسألك يا الله نسألك لهذا اليوم الفضيل أن تكرمنا يا الله. نسألك يا الله علما نافعا ورزقا واسعا وشفاء من كل داء. اللهم اصلح حالنا واصلح أزواجنا وأولادنا جميعا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعدكم لعلكم تذكرون وأقم الصلاة.